PNA Mouse Shortcuts provide quick methods to control measurements and display features. You can find shortcuts by moving the mouse around the screen. Shortcuts exist wherever the cursor changes from an arrow to a hand. At the top of the grid, there are shortcuts for the trace labels, and on the left, for the y-axis labels. Shortcuts are present for the traces, marker symbols, and for the marker readouts. At the bottom of the grid, x-axis labels have shortcuts that control stimulus settings. Right-click on the x-axis labels for a menu of stimulus settings. The top three choices launch dialogs to control sweep frequencies. Next, there's a shortcut to set source power levels. The setup shortcut is useful for changing the sweep type and the basic sweep properties. In this example, we first select a segment sweep, then use the bottom shortcut to show the segment table. The X-axis setup shortcut is an easy way to get dialogs that control options such as mixer measurements, gain compression, intermodulation, and noise. In this example, the top window is a mixer measurement. Choose Setup to adjust the many choices on the SMC dialog. The bottom window is a gain compression measurement. This time, Setup shows the GCA setup dialog. On the left side of the grid, right-click on the Y-axis labels for a menu of choices. Auto Scale acts immediately. The scale item launches a dialog to adjust several Y-axis settings. Click and drag the small triangle to change the reference position. Click and drag over the numbers to adjust the reference level. Double-click over the numbers to auto-scale the active trace. This will also make scale per division the active entry value. Turn the mouse scroll wheel to change the scale. For trace-related shortcuts, right-click on either the trace labels above the grid or on the trace itself. For example, you can add a marker to the selected trace, or you can access memory functions. Drag a triangular marker to the left or right to change its x-axis position. The marker will move along the trace. Right-click on a marker symbol to set marker properties such as delta, discrete, fixed, or coupled markers. These marker properties are on the marker dialog. Right-click to do a marker search such as max or min. Right-click also to apply a marker function such as marker to reference level. The top line of marker readout can be clicked for marker settings or marker display properties. Marker display properties change the way markers are drawn and how their numeric readouts are displayed. Note that line markers can be grabbed anywhere along the line, which is helpful with noisy traces. The marker readout can also be dragged anywhere in the window. Window shortcuts allow you to change the number of windows displayed and what appears within them. Right-click and open part of the window for a menu of choices. First, we add three traces. Next, we add a new window. We can then click and drag a trace from the top window to the bottom window. Now we right-click to close the top window. Drag the window border to change the size of the bottom window. Then right-click on the empty space to select Tile to automatically lay out the remaining windows, eliminating wasted space. Window Zoom allows you to click and drag on a region of the window, then to zoom in on either the X-axis or on both the X and Y axes. Here we show an example of each kind of zoom. To simplify a complicated display, double-click a trace and isolate it. This is called Trace Max. To return, double-click the window. If there are several windows, double-click one window to maximize it. Again, double-click to restore all windows. Each PNA toolbar has mouse shortcuts. At the bottom of the screen, right-click on the status bar to launch the keys dialog. You can then drag the keys dialog and dock it. The buttons on the keys dialog match those on the front panel. Using the keys dialog and the soft keys, you can do anything you could do from the front panel. Right-click on the keys dialog to hide it. At the top of the screen, the entry toolbar shows the current entry value. Click on the up-down arrows to change the value. Right-click to launch a number pad to enter an exact value. Click the undo arrow to go back one or more steps. In this case, restore the previous scale values. You can click on the redo arrow to repeat your earlier changes. To simplify the display, right-click the soft key toolbar and hide it. Finally, right-click on the entry toolbar to hide it as well. We've seen that there are many shortcuts available that simplify common PNA operations, and most of these shortcuts can be used with the touchscreen too. You can create windows and traces, change settings, control markers, and customize the display all with the mouse or with the touch of your finger. Just move the mouse to the screen object that you want to adjust, look for the cursor shaped like a hand, and click to find these shortcuts.